everyone around here has the same experience that I do, that it's flooding more than it used to.
Yeah.
Personally, I have been making decisions to address climate change. But for this project to be successful and for this project to have impact, it doesn't matter what's causing the water to rise. It's an issue we have to deal with, right? Because of the unique shape of the Georgia coastline, we've really been protected from major hurricane impact for as long as people have lived here. But in the last couple of years, things have changed. Because we had evacuated the area, we were watching it on a remote camera. The other thing I was watching, and we all were in this community, watching the official tide gauge at Fort Pulaski, which is about 10 miles from here. From the data we could get, from what we could see, this storm shouldn't have been even as bad as the year before, but in fact, on the ground, reality was a significantly greater flooding event. So, I said, hey, wouldn't it be nice if we had more than one sensor location on the Georgia coast? Because clearly there are a lot of different stories to tell about water level and what the impacts are from these storm events.
This smart sea level sensor program, you know, they're rocking this program to put anywhere up to 100 or so sensors all throughout the coastline of Savannah and surrounding cities, with the idea of once the network is in place, we'll have real-time measurements of the rise and fall of the sea level.
So the steps to go from idea to deployment was a lot of just sharing the idea in the community, getting people to sort of give us feedback on whether this made sense.
Growing up, my friends and my brothers and I, we used to laugh at studies that were put out on almost anything. Because we would always look at each other and say, well, you know, they've been doing this study for the last year and they're talking about the results. Did you get a call? No, I didn't get a call. Did you get a call? No, I didn't get a call. Because they never called the black community, you know? What actually happens is the scientists will come in and do a study and then go back and write their report. They get tenure and that community never sees that scientist or that professor again.
The impacts of storm events, those kinds of things are deeply personal to me. And the piece that is we really drive home with this project, this is a permanent installation for use by the local community.
Well, the city of Savannah, thankfully, suggested they contact Harambe House. One of the reasons why we like their program is that they want to interface with the community and the community residents on, you know, what they're doing, how they're doing it, and hey, maybe you might want to be involved, you know.
So the community response has been phenomenal. It truly is what keeps us going.
We jumped at the idea because now it looks like there are some results that's tangible for these communities and that they're feeling like, okay, maybe I am being heard. And all right, this data that we're now collecting on the sea level rise, you know, we're beginning to see a pattern that we want to break.
It always works better if you meet people where they are with the problem they have today and talk about how we might help address that problem. And if the problem they have today is there's flooding that's happening often, then that's something we can address.
If we can finally show west side of Savannah that all these years of studies and people coming in and asking questions, that it results in having some of these hazards mitigated, then, you know, it's only a win-win-win for Savannah and all its people.